In this video, we'll talk about JDBC with some design pattern. For this example, I'm using MySQL Server 5.1. You can install any database server. You can use SQL Server, you can use Oracle, you can use MS Access, or you can use MySQL, any latest version. So let's create a database first. So we'll say, I have a database with my name, so we'll use that database. So we'll say use Navin. Navin is the database name here. And then in that database, let me create a table. So we'll say create table, and we'll say student. In this, we'll have two variables. We'll say two columns. We'll say roll number, type int, and we'll say size is 5. And we'll say s name. It should be varchar, and the size of varchar will be 25. Now let's insert some values. So we'll say insert into student values. We'll say value is 1, or we'll say value of 11, and we'll say name is Rahul. So we have roll number 11 as Rahul. So inserted. Let's check. So we'll say select star from student, right? So we can see we have a roll number 11 and s name as Rahul. Now what we'll do is, we'll insert some more values. We'll say 12, and instead of Rahul, we'll say Ganesh, and say 13. Oh, this is 13. And say Shadab. So we have three rows. We'll say select star from student. We have these three names. Okay. Now what we'll do is we'll go to our Java code. Now our main task is, from your Java code, you want to fetch name of, let's say, you want a name of roll number 12. That means you need Ganesh. So what we can do is, here we'll say I want a student. We'll say name is S1. I don't know his name. I want to get his name. What I know is roll number. So what I can simply do is I can say get name in bracket for roll number 12. Isn't it? If you write this statement, you will get S name, and you can simply say S out. And then we'll say S1 dot get name. S1 dot we'll say S name. Right? Now the problem is, we don't have this method called as getName. So what we can do is, again, before coming to this video, I will recommend you watch my JDBC basics video so that you will understand what I'm doing here. So we don't have a method called as getName here, right? So we have to define that. So we'll define that method somewhere in this class. We'll say class student DAO. Now what DAO stands here is data access object. And this DAO will have a method called as public string or public student, because it will return a new student. And method name will be getName. Or what we'll do is we'll simply say get student with a roll number 12. So we'll say get student roll number 12. And it will be get student. And this we are passing a variable, we'll say roll number. Simple. And we'll say return. We'll create a student here. We'll say student s equal to new student, and then we can simply say return s. Oh, but hold on, we don't have a class called student here at all. So we'll create a class called student. So we'll say class student. Again, you can create all these classes in different file also. Okay, and in this class we'll have two things. One is roll number, and second is string s name. Okay, so we have a class student with two variables, roll number s name, and here I'm returning a student object. But I don't want to return a blank student. I want to return a student with roll number and name. Now the roll number of student, I know this roll number is equal to roll number. So this s roll number here is this roll number here. Okay. And here I want to call this, so we'll say student DAO. We'll say DAO equal to new student DAO. Okay, and then we can use the object of DAO to call get student. Simple. So now we have now we'll create object of student DAO. It will call get student. In get student, we are passing this roll number 12. So we are getting roll number in roll number we are getting 12. And then that 12 comes here. But what about S name? Because when you return this, S, it should also have S name. And the problem is we don't know what's the S name, right? And that's why we want to fetch that S name from database. So what we'll do is we'll say simply we have to follow those 7 steps of JDBC. So if you want to know the 7 steps, you can go to my previous tutorial on JDBC and you can check 7 steps. So I'm directly jumping to the second step. In this, I have to import a library, which is MySQL driver. I'm done with that. So this is your MySQL driver here. How to add this? You have to go to library, right click, add library, and you can go to MySQL here, somewhere here, MySQL database driver, and you can click on add library. Since we have already done that, so we'll not repeat it again. And here, we'll say we want to load the driver, so we'll say class.forName. Here we'll say we have to mention com.mysql.jdbc.driver. There's a chance that we'll be getting an error, so we'll go for try catch. We'll say surround the block with try catch. We'll go for general exception. And instead of printing using a logger, we can simply print the error using sout. Let's say ex. Okay, now here next step is you want to create object of connection. So we'll say create connection con equal to, since connection is an interface, you can see it's an interface. If you're going to go on connection, it's an interface, right? So we'll say to create object of interface, we require a driver manager dot get connection. It will ask you for 3 parameters. First is connection string, roll number, this connection string, username, and password. So we'll say password is 0, username is root, and we have to say JDBC colon MySQL colon / localhost. Again, a recommendation, if you don't know what I'm doing here or the steps of MySQL or JDBC, go to my previous tutorial. Okay, and then after localhost, we'll say, we'll type the database name, and database name here is database name, it's Navin. Okay, next step, you have to create a statement, so we'll say statement st equal to con dot create statement. Now we need a SQL query, so we'll go up here and we'll say string query equal to. And the query I'm using here is select S name from student where roll number is equal to roll number. Right? So with this roll number will come here and the query will become select S name from student where roll number is equal to 12. Okay. And then we'll say st.execute query, because when you say execute query and you have to pass the query here, it will give you a result set. So we'll say result set rs equal to st.execute query. In this result set, what you'll be getting is the result. Okay, what result you'll be getting is, we'll say select, it's the same query here, we'll say select S name from student where roll number equal to 12. So you're getting here is S name and get Ganesh, right? So by default your pointer will be here and you want to shift to Ganesh here. So we'll say rs.next, you have to shift your pointer, and then we'll print S out, not S out, we don't want to print here. We'll say now we got, how can you fetch the name? We'll say name string name is equal to rs.getString, and then we can pass the column number, and the column number here is 1, is because we are fetching only one column. And then we'll say student, which is s.sname is equal to name. So this name here will go to this sname, and then you can return s here. So this s name is same as this s name. and you can print the S name using the following steps. And now if I run this, we are still having an error. Okay. So we'll say if you get any error, return null. And let's run this. Once you run this code, the output we'll be getting is, there should not be any double quotes here. And when I run this code now, the output is, it's Ganesh, right? So that means, just focus on this now. If you ignore the below part, the student DAO, we're creating a DAO class, and then we are just saying get student with roll number 12, you're getting a S name which is Ganesh. If you write 11 here, and if I run this now, it's Rahul, right? It's that simple. If you don't, if you just see this number of lines, you can achieve your JDBC connection this three number of lines. In fact, if you want to save a student, you can simply say dao.addStudent, and we can pass S1 or maybe S2, creating a new object. It should be that simple. Okay, in fact, we'll do that. We'll add a student using this thing in the next tutorial. I hope you got the thing we are doing here. And thanks for watching. And do subscribe for further videos.